Welcome to Bio-Rad's Blackboard Training. This is a series of short, informal tutorials brought to you by industry experts. Today, we'll cover random allowable error. Before we discuss random allowable error, let's define random error. Random error is also known as imprecision. Random error is a measurement of the ongoing randomness in a test system. It's expressed as the coefficient of variation. It should be noted that each instrument or kit has a certain amount of expected randomness. Some causes of random error are recalibrations, reagent and calibrator lot changes, instrument maintenance, and environmental factors such as temperature and humidity. One method of measuring imprecision is repetitive testing of quality control materials during a time when the measurement procedure is stable. Another method is formal testing using CLSI standards EP5A2 and EP15A. Now that we understand random error, let's define random allowable error. Random allowable error is a predetermined performance goal or precision that a laboratory wishes to achieve for a specific test. To calculate random allowable error, we'll be using formulas described by Dr. Cullum Fraser in his book entitled Biological Variation, From Principles to Practice. We'll need two pieces of information, published within biological variation data, or CVW, and the lab's chosen performance goal. Published BV data can be found in many publications. However, one of the best resources is a database created and maintained by Dr. Carmen Ricos and her colleagues. This database is hosted on Dr. Westgaard's website. Once you have published BV data for CVW, the next step is to choose your lab's desired performance goal from the following options: minimum, desired, or optimum. The minimum goal is intended for labs that lack the resources to achieve desired performance. Desirable is the most widely accepted and frequently used goal. Finally, optimum is intended for those tests that the desirable goal is easily obtained. There are separate formulas for minimum, desirable, and optimum performance. Now let's practice calculating the REA for serum glucose using a performance goal of desirable. Let's move our formula down to the corner just in case we need it. Here's the CVW value for serum glucose. We obtained the value from the database on Dr. Westgaard's site. Let's begin by copying down the formula and then substituting in the CVW value. Next, multiply 0.50 times 5.7%. The REA turns out to be 2.85%. Now let's do a little practice equation on your own. This time we'll use the optimal performance equation for serum calcium. Pause the video when the values appear. This will give you a chance to grab pen, paper, or a calculator. Calculate the REA, then restart the video. I'll provide the correct answer and how I got it. Here's our CVW value. Remember that our formula is in the corner. Go ahead and pause the video now. The REA is 0.475%. Here's how I got that figure. First, I substituted the CVW value into the formula. Then I multiplied 0.25 by the value for CVW. Finally, we have a random allowable error goal of 0.475 for serum calcium. For practical purposes, serum calcium, your random error should not exceed the random allowable error of 0.475%. When random error exceeds random allowable error, the following should be considered. If the performance goal used was optimum or desirable, then action should be taken to determine and correct the possible cause. The urgency is not great. If the performance goal used was minimum, then immediate action should be taken to determine and correct the cause. It's not good practice to widen the performance goal when it's been in use for some time and it's suddenly exceeded. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. For all of your QC needs, visit www.qcnet.com.